Good morning, students. Now our today's chapter is chapter number 12, that is electricity and circuits. In this chapter we will learn about the electricity, and the next topic in this chapter is our circuits. Okay, first of all we will learn about the electricity. So whenever we listen this word electricity, or when we think about the electricity, then the first thing which comes in our mind is electrical appliances. Okay, means if even we can't imagine our life without electricity. In the ancient time, people were not used to with the electricity. They totally depend on the natural environment as well as the natural sources. But in the today's life, or we can say for our luxurious life, for our comfortable life, we need electricity, because this electricity is basically very important for the running of various electrical appliances which make our life easier and comfortable. Okay, even if you will imagine, suppose in the hot summer night, if the electricity in your house will holes, okay, then, or there will be no electricity, then you will be left perspiring in the dark. Perspiring in the dark means you were sweating in the dark, because it is hot summer night, and if there is no light, that means there will be no fan or air conditioners, coolers, nothing will be run. Okay, so you will be left with sweating, and you will not be able to even do any kind of work. Even when you will reach out for a candle or a torch for light, okay, then also after some time they will also get off. Fine, so these resources of light removes darkness but cannot run a fan. They will not give you a comfortable or easy life. Okay, so for that, to run a fan or any other electrical device, you need electricity. So electricity is one or the other form of energy. It is a form of energy which makes our lives comfortable or easier. Okay, whatever work we do, that will become easier with the help of electricity. Okay, it is easily convertible to other forms. Even suppose, now see, this electricity can be converted into other forms like doorbells. Okay, what happens, your doorbells are totally electrical generated. Fine, so where this electricity will convert into sound energy. Here electrical energy converts into sound energy. Fine, next, iron. In that, electrical energy converts into heat energy. Fine, next, bulb or tube light. Again electrical energy converted into light energy. Here heat energy, here sound energy. Okay, so there are so many examples of different appliances in which the electrical energy converts into the another form of energy. That means this electricity or the electrical energy is very, very convertible into the different forms of energy. Okay, and even this electrical energy can flow through cables also. Okay, it flows through cables, which makes it easy to transport. Even in your home, this electricity comes through cables only. Okay, electricity is used to power many devices, which makes our work easier. It provides both light and heat energy, and electricity is supplied to different parts of a city by power stations. Fine, because mainly the electricity is generated at the power stations, and from the power stations the electricity is supplied to the houses. Okay, to the different houses. Now when it is dark, what we do, We illuminate our surroundings. We turn on this. We turn the switch of tube light or bulb. Okay, by switching the light bulbs, which run on electricity. Thus, electricity lights our homes, offices, roads, factories, etc. Even electric energy is converted into the light energy through a medium of electric bulbs or tube lights. Here, I already explained you. Next, many of us relish or just want to eat chutneys. In olden days, what happened? People have or your they do lots of physical work. Okay, on with the help of a we can say grinder, mortar and pestle. In that they used to grind the chutneys. But nowadays mixers and grinders are there, which makes our very easier, which makes our work very easier. Just they run on electricity with a one push to the switch. Okay, it will you will get your favorite chutney. Okay, even the vacuum cleaner is used to clean your homes. Washing machines are used to clean your clothes. But if we will compare the work to the ancient time, then all of that work requires physical work. Okay, lots of physical work. Many heavy machines like cranes also run on electrical energy. Now, in the cold weather, when we prefer warm water for bath, then even for that we need geyser. Nowadays we are using geysers, which runs on electricity. Again, when we wear iron clothes, we need iron. That iron also runs on electricity, and it converts it into heat energy. Okay, this is made possible by geysers and irons, which run on electricity. Thus, electricity is used to produce heat also. Okay, so there are so many uses of electricity. Our complete life is totally surrounded, I can say that our whole life or whatever our day-to-day functions or day-to-day chaos or cause of the livelihood, they all requires electricity. We are now in that age in which our life is totally dependent on electricity. Without electricity, we can't imagine our life. So students, that's all for today. In the next class, we will learn about the electric cell.